This program is made possible by the giving of the God-called partners of Renner Ministries. Stay tuned for a teaching you can trust, a message that will inspire, strengthen, and equip you with vital insights and understanding from the Word of God. Here is Rick.
Hey friend, this is Rick Renner, and right now, I want to say thank you for making time for me to come into your space so I can minister to you from the promises of God in the 91st Psalm. These promises are so amazing, and I just have to give you my personal testimony that through all the years that Denise and I have been doing what we have done, and we've done some amazing things in very difficult parts of the world, we have lived with the promises of Psalm 91 in our mouth, and we've activated them, and we have seen their reality. And I want the promises of the 91st Psalm to be your reality too. I really do. I'm praying this for you. It's why I'm teaching this series. And by the way, if you're a partner, thank you for helping me take the teaching of the Bible to people all over the world. You're really helping somebody else. And I think it's amazing that without ever leaving your house, by just going online and giving a gift or sending a gift in the mail, you can make a difference in somebody else's life. I say it has never been easier to be a missionary. You don't even have to leave your couch. You just go online, give something to help the work of the ministry, and bam, you've touched another life. And that is amazing. But if you're a partner, I want to say thank you for helping me do this. And thank you for helping me to teach this series on the 91st Psalm. But I want everybody to have a copy of the 91st Psalm. So we have designed the 91st Psalm very beautifully like this. And you can go online and download it. If you have a printer, you can print it at home. If you don't, then call the number on the screen or send us an email, and we will slip a paper version of this to you in the mail, which you can frame when you get. But keep Psalm 91 in front of you. Denise and I have quoted it when we've walked out the door, when we've stepped into the car, stepped onto an airplane. We have quoted with long life. Will He satisfy me and show me His salvation? He will give His angels charge over me to keep me in all of my ways. They'll bear me up in their hands lest I dash my foot against a stone. There shall no evil befall me. 1,000 will fall at my side and 10,000 at my right hand, but it will not come nigh me. We have personalized it in our life, and that's what we're commanded to do in Psalm 91, verse 2, where it says, I will say of the Lord. The Hebrew actually says, I will say to the Lord. The 91st Psalm is supposed to be a faith declaration, and that's why I'm teaching it to you. I want you to get these words in your mouth, but please order the entire series, which is called The Protective Promises of Psalm 91. And the subtitle says, Laying Claim to Every Promise in the 91st Psalm. It is just so rich and really practical and easy to understand. And it comes with a great study guide. You know, you might know somebody who confesses bad stuff all the time. They might be saying, well, I'm afraid of this, and I'm just worried about this, and I'm afraid of this. They have the wrong words in their mouth. They need to put the Psalm 91 promises in their mouth and activate those promises. There's no reason for anybody to live in fear because we have protective promises which have been made to us. Say amen. Anyway, you can order this by going online or by giving us a call. And please order Vicki Burke's amazing book, which is called Help, It Is Dangerous Out There. The subtitle says, How to Walk in Supernatural Protection. God wants you to walk in supernatural protection. And if you feel it's dangerous out there, and by the way, it is, then you need to read Vicki's book because it will really show you how to walk in supernatural protection. Wow. And by the way, when you reach out to us, always let us know how to pray for you because we're praying people and we really want to pray for you. And if you'll let us know how to pray, we'll release our faith. And I promise you, Jesus will move. He will do something spectacular. But call us or write to us and let us know how to pray for you. But reach for your Bible. We always use the Bible in this program, and today we're going to return to the 91st Psalm. And as we have seen, the 91st Psalm was written by Moses when he was leading the children of Israel in the wilderness. There they had been living in Egypt for over 400 years. They had forgot about life in the wilderness, and now they're out in the middle of the wilderness facing things they haven't faced for centuries. They're facing enemies. They're facing ferocious beasts. They're facing snakes. They're facing all kinds of wild, crazy attacks, and they're dealing with the spirit of fear. And so Moses wrote to them and said, hey, these are the promises of God for anyone who abides in the shadow of the Almighty. So let's begin in Psalm 91, verse 1. He that dwells in the secret place of the Most High. We've seen that that word dwelleth is a Hebrew word which means to dwell, to lodge, to take up residency. It pictures a person that's moved into a location and they're never going to move out of it. The secret place in this verse describes a secret compartment or a secret chamber, a place of hiding. And really it describes you and me being in Christ Jesus. When we got saved, we were placed in Christ. That is the secret place. And my friends, He is our hiding place. We're deeply tucked away in the person of Jesus Christ. Say amen. He is your secret place. But as I said in the last program, many people are in that secret place. They're saved. They know the Lord, but they're no longer walking with Him as they once did, but they're trying to lay claim to these promises. But these promises don't belong to them. These promises belong to those who abide under the shadow of the Almighty. You've got to abide there. That word abide means to dwell, to lodge, to reside. You've got to reside. You've got to lodge. You've got to dwell in the shadow of the Almighty. And the word shadow depicts this shelter, a hiding place, but it denotes one who is in the shadow of the Almighty because he's staying in step with the Lord. And let me use the illustration again. If you want to be in my shadow, then you got to walk very close to me because I'm moving and my shadow is moving with me. And if I'm moving and you're not, then you're not in my shadow. The only way you're going to stay in my shadow is if you're alongside me, walking with me, staying in step with me. And likewise, you can be saved. You can be in the secret place. You can be in Christ. But that does not mean automatically all these promises are yours, because these promises are really activated in the lives of those who are living in the shadow of the Almighty. They're walking with the Lord. They're in step with the Lord. And the word Almighty here is the word Shaddai, which means the great provider, the one who overpowers, which means when you're walking in the shadow of the Almighty, you're shadowed and you are sheltered with His divine protection and His amazing provision. It belongs to whoever is abiding in the shadow of the Almighty. So my friends, walk with the Lord, stay in the shadow of the Almighty. But all of Psalm 91 verse 2 says, and I will say of the Lord. And we've seen that the Hebrew actually says, I will say to the Lord. This is a personal confession and faith declaration. You got to get these words in your mouth. Get bad words out of your mouth. Put these words in your mouth. I will say to the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God. In Him will I trust. Now, we covered that in the last program. Today, we're going to look at verse 3. And in verse 3, the Bible says, surely. Ugh. Don't you love that? Surely. The word surely in Hebrew means but, certainly, doubtless, of a certainty. It is a conjunction in the Hebrew language to make a very dramatic point. Surely, absolutely, certainly, doubtless, He shall cover thee, deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. This is the promise of what God will do for anyone who lives and abides in His shadow. If you get out of the shadow, this doesn't work for you. But when you're in the shadow of the Almighty, He delivers you from the snare of the fowler and He delivers you from the noisome pestilence. You say, well, what does that mean? Well, first of all, let's look at the two words, shall deliver. Surely, emphatically, of a certainty, doubtless, He shall deliver thee. Shall deliver in Hebrew means to snatch away into safety. It's the idea of one that is escaping or one that is being defended. Here is a person that was under assault and all of a sudden, bam, they're snatched away. They're carried into safety. They are delivered. And here we have a promise that if you're staying in step with the Lord and living in His shadow, walking right alongside of Him, it is the promise that in His shadow, you'll be snatched out of every attack and carried into a place of safety. That is the promise of God. You need to get it in your mouth. Get it in your mouth. Say it to the Lord. Make it your faith declaration. But wait. It says, surely, emphatically, of a certainty, doubtless, He will emphatically deliver you from the snare of the fowler. From the snare is from a Hebrew word which describes a bird trap. And it was used figuratively of calamities and evil devices and wicked plots which are set to ensnare people. Here it's called the snare of the fowler. The word fowler describes a fowler or a bird trapper, but it depicts one who intentionally sets a trap to entangle and to capture. Have you ever dealt with somebody who intentionally tried to entangle you and set a trap for you and capture you? It is used figuratively to picture a sinister plan to entangle a person. But this verse says, if you abide in the shadow of the Almighty, surely, emphatically, of a certainty, He will deliver you. He'll snatch you out of it. He'll carry you into a place of safety. He'll take you out of the trap of the fowler, the sinister plan that has been set to entangle you. And again, it is the image of a net. Now listen to this. Like a fowler, the devil, wicked men, even demons, often try to attack, and they operate in stealth so they can try to catch a victim. You don't always realize what they're doing, but they're secretly, clandestinely working, trying to set a trap to catch you and to take you down. And sometimes they change their methods so that they cannot be detected. The word snare depicts this trap that wicked men, the devil, demons set, trying to devise a plan against the people of God. It is a trap. It is a plan. It is a plot, a scheme to hurt. It is a device to damage or even to kill. And I like to think about the many times that the Pharisees and the Sadducees tried to entangle Jesus in His words. And in fact, they even set up situations and asked Him questions publicly, hoping they would entangle Him and entrap Him in conversations. It was very sinister what they were doing, but Jesus was delivered from the snare of the fowler every single time. But let me give you some examples. In Matthew 16, verse 1, the Bible says, the Pharisees also with the Sadducees came tempting Him. They were setting a snare for Him. In Matthew 19, verse 3, the Bible says, the Pharisees also came unto Him, tempting Him and saying unto Him, is it lawful for man to put away his wife for every cause? They were trying to create a theological debate that would ensnare Him in words so He would make a mistake. It was very sinister what they were doing. Or in Matthew 22, verse 15, the Bible says, then went the Pharisees and took counsel how they might entangle Him in His talk. They were setting a snare for Him, trying to entangle Him in His talk. You need to be very careful when people are trying to entangle you. Listen to the Holy Spirit. He'll show you how to be delivered from the snare of the fowler. Or how about Mark 12, verse 13? And they sent unto Him certain of the Pharisees and of the Herodians to catch Him in His words. There they were setting a snare for Him, trying to entangle Him. Or how about Luke 11, 53 to 54? And as He said these things unto them, the scribes and the Pharisees began to urge Him and to provoke Him to speak of many things, lying in wait for Him and seeking to catch something out of His mouth that they might accuse Him. They were setting a trap for Him, trying to ensnare Him. Here we find the snare of the fowler. But every single time they tried to ensnare Jesus, Jesus was delivered from the snare of the fowler. But let's look at another example. How about the example of Haman in the Old Testament? Haman, who hated the Jews and wanted to exterminate all of the Jews, and he concocted a device, a plot, to exterminate all of the Jews. And he really thought that this plot was going the way that he wanted it to go, and even built gallows 75 feet tall in the very center of the city, believing he was going to hang every single Jew on those gallows. He was setting a trap for them. But the plan backfired, and the Jews were saved, and it was Haman who was hung on the very gallows that he had built to exterminate the Jews. In the end, he was ensnared in his own trap. Now that is just amazing. But then when you come to Psalm 140, verses 1 to 5, we find David praying to be delivered from the traps set by evil men. Listen to what he said in Psalm 140, verse 1. Deliver me, O Lord, from the evil man. Preserve me from the violent man. Verse 2. which imagine mischiefs in their heart continually, are they gathered together for war. Verse 3, they have sharpened their tongues like a serpent's adder's poison is under their lips. Verse 4, keep me, O Lord, from the hands of the wicked. Preserve me from the violent man who have purposed to overthrow my goings. Verse 5, the proud have hid a snare for me and cords. They have spread a net by the wayside. They have set gins for me. But listen to it in the New Living Translation. Psalm 140, 1-5. O Lord, rescue me from evil people. Protect me from those who are violent, those who plot evil in their hearts and stir up trouble all day long. Their tongues sting like a snake. The venom of a viper drips from their lips. O Lord, keep me out of the hands of the wicked. Protect me from those who are violent, for they're plotting against me. The proud have set a trap to catch me. They have stretched out a net. They placed traps all along the way. David prayed to be delivered from the snare of the fowler. But listen to these amazing promises which God makes to you and me, that he will deliver us from those who try to take us down. And in fact, these words promise us the evil will be ensnared in their own traps. Listen to this. Psalm 35, 7-8. For without cause have they hid for me their nets in a pit, which without cause they have digged for my soul. Let destruction come upon him at unawares, and let his net, which he hath hid, catch himself into the very destruction. Let him fall. His own net is going to catch himself. Or how about Proverbs 26, verse 27? Whoso diggeth a pit shall fall therein, and he that rolleth a stone, it will return upon him himself. Or how about Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verse 8? He that diggeth a pit shall fall into it, and whoso breaketh a hedge, a serpent shall bite him. Wow. Or listen to what Paul said in 2 Thessalonians 1, 6 in the King James Version. Then I'm going to give you the RIV. And in the King James Version, 2 Thessalonians 1, 6 says, seeing it is a righteous thing with God to recompense tribulation to them that trouble you. But listen to the RIV of 2 Thessalonians 1, 6. Listen, God is always just and equitable, so you can be sure that he will repay the people who put you through all this misery. He will reimburse those who have afflicted you and see to it that they receive a full settlement of double trouble for the traumatic circumstances they put you through. God has a habit of being fair, so you can be certain he will make sure everyone gets exactly what is deserved. That is just amazing. My friends, God's going to take care of you if you abide in the shadow of the Almighty. Now, if you get out of that shadow, you're going to be in trouble. But if you're keeping in step with the Lord, he goes on to promise you that you will be delivered from the noisome pestilence. Look at Psalm 91, verse 3 again. And he shall surely deliver thee from the snare of the fowler. We've already covered that. And from the noisome pestilence. The word noisome in Hebrew describes the deadly pestilence. It can also be translated greedy. Very often an attack is based on greed. Someone is not happy that you have what you have, or they're jealous of your position. It's a greedy attack. The word noisome can be translated destructive. It can be translated mischievous. It can be translated naughty or perverse. And figuratively, this word noisome speaks of the evil devices of people. I tell you, I've dealt with a few of them in my life. I really have. It is amazing the traps that people try to set for you. But you know what I found? If you walk in the shadow of the Almighty, they have no power against you. God delivers you from them, exactly what he promises in this verse. He rescues you and takes you into a place of safety. But what does the word pestilence mean? The word pestilence in Hebrew could be translated pestilence or plague, and it describes thorns. And figuratively, it speaks of sticky or thorny situations. And what is really interesting is this word pestilence is related to a Hebrew word that means to speak. And here, it infers sticky or thorny situations due to spoken words. Words spoken against you, people gossiping about you, people spreading rumors about you, thorny situations as the result of words that should have never been spoken. These are devices that have been set against you. But this verse says, surely he shall deliver. Again, the word surely, emphatically, of a certainty, doubtless he shall deliver. He will snatch you out of that place, take you into a place of safety if you abide in the shadow of the Almighty. He will deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. But noisome pestilence also describes a great calamity that comes by surprise. God will even deliver you from surprise calamities. It depicts a tragedy that hits suddenly and sweeps everything away in its destruction. But the Lord, by His powerful presence, protects His people. He protects every believer that is abiding under His shadow so that deadly, ruinous, and destructive things have no power against them. It is diffused because you're living and abiding in the shadow of the Almighty. Those who trust God, those who stay in step with the Lord, those who abide in the shadow of the Almighty are promised God will deliver them in all events like I've been describing for you today. So Psalm 91:3 fully says, surely, emphatically, of a surety, doubtless, he shall deliver you. He will pick you up, snatch you out of your situation, carry you into safety. He will deliver you from the snare of the fowler, that sinister attack, and from the noisome pestilence. But Psalm 91 verse 2 begins by saying, I will say of the Lord, that's the King James Version. The Hebrew says, I will say to the Lord, which means now we need to say this to the Lord and we need to personalize it. So let's personalize it. Read the words on the screen, say it out loud with me. You deliver me from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. That is a promise that can be claimed and activated by anyone who is living in the shadow of the Almighty and by anybody who puts the promise in their mouth. You've got to put it in your mouth. It's not enough just to think about it or ponder it. You've got to say it. I will say to the Lord, surely he will deliver me from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence, or you deliver me from the snare of the fowler and you deliver me from the noisome pestilence. That is yours to claim if you're staying in step with the Lord, living in his shadow, and if you're putting that in your mouth as your faith confession. I'll be back in just a moment. And I'm going to pray for you.
Psalm 91 is packed full of protective promises for every believer who abides in the shadow of the Almighty. The Bible promises that when you live under God's mighty shadow, no evil can touch you and no plague or sickness will come near you. In fact, if you live under God's mighty shadow, angels are assigned to watch over you. In this insightful series, Rick will answer questions like, how do you dwell in the shadow of the Almighty? How does God deliver you from the snare of the fowler? How is it possible for no sickness to come near you? This 10-part series, The Protective Promises of Psalm 91, laying claim to every promise in the 91st Psalm, will show you how to lay claim to these protective promises. And it is available in digital or physical format, starting at just $20. In addition, we want to offer you Vicki Burke's powerful book, Help, It's Dangerous Out Here. In this book, you'll learn the secrets to avoiding deadly mistakes, the intentional steps you can take to overcome fear, and the keys to living with immunity from the devil's attacks. You'll also learn how to operate with an unshakable confidence in God's supernatural protection. Today, this book can be yours for $15. Don't miss this bundle offer of the 10-part series, The Protective Promises of Psalm 91, laying claim to every promise in the 91st Psalm. And the book, Help, It's Dangerous Out Here. And be sure to request your free design print of Psalm 91. Or visit Renner.org to download a copy. Call the number on your screen. Or visit Renner.org to order. Call or go online now.
Hey friends, this is Rick Renner, and I'm so excited that today I can come to you from our Tulsa, Oklahoma headquarters building, and I'm standing in the production department where we produce so many resources for people who live all over the ends of the earth that reach out to us for teaching that they can trust. And I know that's the call of God on our life. Proverbs 10:21 says, The lips of the righteous feed many, and our job is to feed many the wonderful Word of God. And right now, we're wanting to retire the debt on this building so it frees up funds so we can take the Bible to further places across the world. If you're part of the giving team, thank you. And if not, please pray about becoming a part of our giving team so we can take the transforming truths of God's Word to people all around the world. And together we'll retire the debt on this building, and it will free up finances so we can reach those that are crying out for answers from God's Word. I am so glad you've been with me today. Tomorrow we're going to be back and we're going to continue. It is going to be so good, but please go online and download your copy of the 91st Psalm. It's beautifully designed. If you have a printer at home, you can print it yourself. If you don't have a printer at home, then call us or email us and we'll send you a paper copy, which you can frame like I have framed mine. And please order the whole series, which is called The Protective Promises of Psalm 91, Laying Claim to Every Promise in the 91st Psalm. And again, it comes with a study guide. And we're also offering you the amazing book by Vicki Burke, which is called Help, It's Dangerous Out There, How to Walk in Supernatural Protection. You really can. And when you reach out to us to order all these things by going online or calling us, also let us know how to pray for you, because we're going to stand in faith for you to be delivered from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence in Jesus' name. But put your hand on your heart. I'm going to pray for you right now. Father, I pray for my friend. You promise that if they live in your shadow, they will be delivered from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. And my friend, I speak divine supernatural protection and deliverance over you right now in the wonderful name of Jesus. Say amen. Amen. Denise and I are going to be coming to the United States, and we're going to be ministering in some churches. And if you can join us, please try to come to one of the following meetings. On Sunday, January 28th, we'll be with Pastors Mark and Rhonda Garver at the Cornerstone Word of Life Church in Madison, Alabama. On Saturday and Sunday, February 3rd and 4th, we're going to be with Pastors Jim and Ann Fries at the Joy Church in Mount Juliet, Tennessee. On Sunday, February 18th, we'll be with Pastor Frederick Price Jr. and Lady Angel Price at the Crenshaw Christian Center Faith Dome in Los Angeles, California. And on Tuesday and Wednesday, February 27th and 28th, we'll be with Pastor Jerry Moore at the Word of Life Church in Miami, Florida. I cannot begin to tell you how happy Denise and I would be to see you in one of those meetings, but please go online for more detailed information.
If you've never received Jesus as your Savior and Lord, now is the time for you to experience a new life Jesus has to give you. Pray this prayer with me right now. Lord, I repent of my sin and receive you as my Savior and Lord. Wash away my sin and make me completely new. I thank you that my sin is removed and Satan no longer has any right to lay claim on me. I faithfully promise that I will serve you as my Lord for the rest of my life. Amen.